personal? What is your personal responsibility?
So if you read my speech, and many people have done it, and I've seen it both in the papers and in the media, on television, it's been analyzed, and people thought that what I said was totally appropriate.
There is a theme from the Greek philosopher Socrates in which he says, in a true tragedy, both sides are right. Tragedies have existed throughout our history. We simply need to recall the Hitler period. On the 6th of January 2021, it reared its ugly head in the capital of the United States of America. Americans may not have known what would transpire, but everyone expected something to happen. Yet the country was unprepared for it. Both sides continue to believe that they are right. They feel that the other side is misleading and need to grasp their point of view. The real tragedy is that people will defend their position until the other gives in. Everyone is a participant. Due to his personality, Donald Trump was the right person at the right time for the wrong reasons and the wrong outcome. I have watched analysts try to put meaning and make sense of the situation. They scrutinize the parts that they have assembled and then try to create a bigger picture from it. The trap is that they focus on what is currently taking place and do not realize that all political tragedies use the same platform. The delivery product may appear different. Until we understand what glue holds all the fragments together, we will struggle with the moving parts. Ultimately, all political problems are people problems. We can understand this misfortune from a neurological, psychological, and social platform and the impact on ourselves and others. No person is an island. Even though we may often wish to withdraw into the privacy of our minds and be isolated, we would not survive. People working together is a necessary and vital part of our human experience and survival. Currently, the whole world is experiencing the fragmentation of that survival process. We now have factions adversarial to one another, with a loss of empathy for those against whom they rebel. These divisions have always existed. It usually started with nations or cultures facing off against each other. Now we have groups within nations who are warring amongst themselves. Typically, controlling the situation has been to suppress it by force, change the rules, or create new governing laws. But we have now reached a stage where there are uncontrollable growth and amplification of these factions. The qualities which predominate are rage, violence, and destruction. There is not a singular cause for this process. The roles of social media, religion, politics, and individuals all have to be accountable for this. The finger pointing has to start with each of us at us. we all can influence the change that we want to see in others. The common excuse usually is, what change can I make in a situation that is so overpowering? The other position is to project the responsibility to others who are elected or paid to do the job. We want you to know that you have more power than you think. Others are using the same process to cause disharmony, while those who can prevent this chaos sit on the sidelines. The answers to these questions begin in a part of the human brain known as the mirror neuron system. If we were to create a group of people who know nothing about each other, a human process would automatically unfold. Within a few hours, a dominant leader will emerge. Some will support and enable that leader. Others will be passive or resent the control they're allowing the dominant person to have. This is what happens in human behavior. Mirror neurons is the communication system that flows within the group, allowing this process to take place. In the next episode, we will talk about how mirror neurons used by dominant individuals, groups, and cultures can trigger chaos and destruction.
We're gathered together in the heart of our nation's capital for one very, very basic and simple reason: to save our democracy.